went to be wed in the land of Tirnanahmiet.
What happened to the gumdrop princesses after that, Grandma?
Oh, the usual thing. Gender inequality, domestic abuse, good night, dear.
Grandma, that is not a nice story. Now I shan't be able to sleep.
Well, I don't know any made-up stories, and I'm nicely, I'm afraid. Go to bed.
Well, then, tell me a real story. About you, Grandma. About when you were younger. About when you met Grandpa.
It all started when I boarded Death Ship 666 on its maiden voyage to the Bermuda Triangle. I should have paid closer attention to the name, or perhaps the brochure. What I thought was a picturesque view of a beautiful sunset was in fact the exploding of lifeboats. It was women and children first.
Grandma, I really don't think this is the kind of story that's going to help me sleep.
It was meant to be the ship of dreams, but it wasn't. Really wasn't.
And so much more! Bye, everyone! Bye!
Have you ever seen anything so death-defying?
Even that vengeful bastard God himself couldn't sink that ship!
God, check this way! Precious riddle!
Lars, check this way! We don't know where this... Has anyone seen where this goes?
Sugar, dates and figs! Sugar, dates and pistachios!
T-shirts! Get your sunk to death ship 666 T-shirts!
Oh, my God, honey, let's get some for the girls.
That's a swell idea. Let's get matching ones for us as well. Hey, mister, wait up.
I'll get my purse.
Hi, everybody. Welcome aboard Death Ship 666. I'll be your tour guide on its maiden voyage to the Bermuda Triangle.
Builders, coming through.
Pass me the gaffer tape. There's an hole in the hull.
Right, Ned.
Right. I'll see you later.
Don't let the builders put you off. They're due to finish construction mid-voyage. Emergency exits are non-existent, but we do have two lifeboats. The other one's nearly finished, so that's good. Safety talk over. Let the tour of Death Ship 666 begin!
All aboard Death Ship 666. Names, passes, wristbands. Name, please.
Grandma. Just Grandma. Oh.
That's funny, I had a grandmother by that name. Now, do you have children that have children?
No, not yet.
Well, time's a ticking, my love. Wait a minute, though. I know your face, you're the captain's niece.
That's right. Have you seen my husband?
John Deville Crapwire, the ship's evil electrician.
My darling John.
Yes, 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 he's already on board the ship.
Oh.
Go to him.
Thank you.
Next!
No! I said no, I'm not getting on this ship! Going to sink, I tell you, we're all going to die!
Nonsense! Taking a trip to the Bermuda Triangle is the perfect cure for your fear of drowning. So I'm telling you, paranoid woman, nothing bad is going to happen aboard the ship. So just get on board and try not to drown. Explode. Just go. Fit in.
Okay, Doctor, if you think it's best.
Next!
Get out of our way, we're rich!
Names, please.
Rich lady.
Rich man.
Next story. We're the heavily insured investors on board Death Ship 666.
Oh, we might be under our company name, Mega Scam.
Oh, yes, Mega Scam. Now, are you here for work or pleasure?
We're here to make sure everything...
explodes. Explodes.
Explodes with fun. He means explodes with fun.
What a fun couple. You go and have a fun day now.
One always has a fun day when one is rich.
You're always doing this, running off at the mouth, and then we end up having to kill someone.
Oh, hello, little girl.
Are you lost?
Holly Hobby, 10 years old, private eye. I'm here to investigate this vessel. My sources tell me there's something afoot on Death Ship, and I'm going to find out who's responsible and report them to the appropriate authorities.
Yeah, dear, that's nice. Go on, off you go, that way now. Come on, let's be able.
Is the captain?
The captain!
The captain.
Who's coming?
At ease, by your leisure. Rest in peace, head, shoulders, knees and toes. Always believe in your soul.
Yes, captain, we will.
Do you smell that? Huh? That is the smell of adventure. They told me I was mad. But I escaped from that asylum, and I built the most testifying ship time and space we'll ever see. So, when we get to Bermuda, it's pina coladas for everyone still alive.
He's so inspirational.
Stop it. Don't
Captain,
stop it.
Captain! Oh, Captain! You can't be serious about this!
I am serious, Mr. Architect! If we were any more serious, I'd be dead. But that's not going to happen for another 34 years.
Oh, this ship's going to be setting sail for another 10 months. We don't have a rudder. We don't have a bottom deck.
Time waits for no man, Mr. Architect. Sometimes you've just got to be bold and punch life in the face and hope it doesn't try and drown you in the middle of the Atlantic.
Oh, I am telling you, if this ship casts off, it will sink.
Cast off!
Cast off!
Mr. Architect, but I've made some changes of my own to ensure at least half of the ship's safety.
What? You mean those radiators on the front of the ship?
No iceberg is going to sneak up on us. Not this time. I'm a man of vision, Mr. Architect. I've an eye on the future. And on the past. But I know what's worrying you, Mr. Architect, and there is no need to fret. This ship is possibly the safest place you can be away from.
No! Don't say it.
Your tragic past!
Architect! No. No.
Those bears shouldn't have done what they did to your fiancé. It's over now. They're all gone and there's no one left to avenge them.
Yes, I suppose.
Except their cubs, of course, and they'll all be grown up right about now. But there's no reason to think they're already on board the ship, plotting revenge as we speak.
Have you seen my husband? Have you seen my husband? Whoa!
Oh, hi, Uncle. Captain, have you seen my husband?
Grandma, now you're here, I've a letter from your mother to read to you immediately. Get off. Dear Grandma, if your uncle is reading this, then I am dead and I died horribly alone. Remember, a womb has a sell-by date, and I died lonely without great-grandchildren. Have a child, so that they may have one too. Love, your mother, great-grandma.
And John!
Oh, wait!
Oh, who was that?
That was my elegantly highly strung niece, Grandma!
Oh, she's beautiful, yet ever so tragic. Troubled somehow.
And she's married to your arch nemesis, I believe.
What? John! John Deville Crapwire!
The very same! He's also the ship's evil electrician and stands to inherit everything of my disgustingly wealthy family's fortune should we all die in a tragic, unforeseen circumstance.
Oh, no, Captain, you don't understand. I've known John Deville Crapwire since my schoolboy days. He's bad news! He once wired a train and everybody on board died.
Sometimes trains crash.
They were electrocuted in their seats!
Captain, there's a flock of icebergs heading this way!
They found me! Radiators full blast, and the trebuchets, and get me my shotgun.
Aye, aye, Captain. I love you.
Now, if you'll excuse me, Mr. Architect, I've got some ice bugs to kill.
John Deville Crapwire. We first met years ago when we attended Architectural Electrical Intellectual College. We became fast friends, what with his electrical spark and my architectural genius. But John, he wasn't like the rest of us. Oh no, he was poor. His hate returned to bitterness and it drove him mad. On the day of our graduation, he rigged the electrics to burn down the ceremony and then scarpered without a trace. But now he's here. He's here on Death Ship!
Am I ears burning? Oh, hello, Architect.
Electrician.
fact you're on this ship has jeopardized every life on board.
Is that any way to greet an old friend? Hm? It's clear that money can't buy you manners.
Manners? Don't you even know what you...
It's not worth it.
Thousands died that day because of what you did.
I haven't the faintest idea what you're talking about. Now, if you'll excuse me, some of us have got work to be getting on with.
I don't know what your agenda is on board this ship, but I am going to check every single wire to prove you're evil!
My agenda is to kill everyone and steal all of their money.
My darling John.
Oh, for Christ's sake.
John, I've been looking all over the ship for you.
Not now, Grandma. I'm working to a deadline. Deadline.
Well, everything's arranged. The Vanderbilts, the Vanderfrills, and the Vandergandalfs have all confirmed.
Confirmed to what?
The baby shower. I took the liberty of painting the baby's room yellow, as we don't yet know if it's a girl or a boy. As we haven't conceived yet, John. We haven't actually consummated the marriage yet.
I told you, I'll consummate the marriage when we get to Bermuda. Now leave me alone. I'm busy plotting.
Oh, always busy plotting, aren't you? Wish you'd plot me. In a while.
Why don't you go? Start without me.
I can't do this without you, John. Tell me you love me. Tell me you love me and I'll forgive you everything.
Did you say something?
You're breaking my heart.
And you're breaking my concentration!
John! How can you shout at a woman who wasn't even pregnant?
There's something terribly wrong with these wires. I can't quite work it out. I must warn everybody immediately or the whole ship could catch fire at any moment. All I've got to do is...
Wait a minute! It's Grandma! Hey, Grandma! Wait up!
Now, darling, we ain't had a vacation in about 10 years, and we saved up so much money for this one, but I couldn't resist. I had to buy this Death Ship mug in the gift shop.
Oh, my God! Ditto!
Oh, boy, the trail ends here. Holly Hobby, Private Eye, can I see some identification, please?
Oh, hell, darling. Honey, where are the passports?
They're in my fanny pack.
Keep your hands where I can see them.
Oh, look how cute her outfit is.
Looks like these check out.
Here's a little pocket money for you to spend in duty free.
Well, I don't take bribes, mister. But I'll see it as an investment. Thank you. As soon as I get enough dough together, I'm going to open the Holly Hobby Detective Agency. Yeah.
Grandma, it's me, Architect. Just slow down.
Crime never sleeps. And don't think I've forgotten about you two. I'll be right back for a urine song.
Oh, such a darling little girl. And did you see her adorable bow?
I sure did.
Oh my God, we should get some for the girls.
Oh my God, I wonder if they have them in duty free. Let's check that right now, darling. How I love myself a little bit of duty free.
Shut up and get home with it. Are you done yet, huh?
We'll have that Guinness later. Bye.
That's third class and second class done. I'll come back later and set the timers.
Good. Oh, I hate poor people. We just need to make sure that we're at the life base before the bombs go off.
Come on! Just slow down for 1 second!
Stop right there! I've got some questions for you! I don't think I've forgotten about you two. I'll be right back to cross-examine you. Crime doesn't have a bedtime.
Oh my God! She knows! She'll tell everyone! We'll be ruined! We'll be poor!
Shut up! Just shut the hell up!
You're hurting me again!
Now listen to me! Everything's going to plan. We plant the bombs, destroy the ship, and cash in on a disaster!
Righto.
Well, come on then! We need to be 3 steps ahead of this savvy detective. After her!
Yes, darling.
Do not make me...
Grandma!
run if I were you.
Why?
Because it's really, really cold. So cold you can't blink.
Oh. Okay, well, I'll just...
Nearly fell. Oh, my God.
No!
Just, no!
I'm architect. I'm slightly embarrassed.
I'm grandma. I'm slightly aroused.
Get off him! Get off him! Come on, get off him! Get off him! Did she hurt you? Let me grab you. Get good one. Hey, hey, you'll be fine. Wow.
I thought this ship was class divided.
What's going on? Holly Hobby here, nothing to fear. Now, with my trusty Holly Hobby notebook, you tell me exactly what happened.
Right, well, Holly.
Yes.
I was at the edge of the ship trying to see the wobble.
Roulette wheel.
Turkeys.
Propellers.
No, propellers.
Well, propellers aren't that scary, are they? No.
I was looking at... It's gone.
Propellers!
Wait, I thought I saw a bear.
A bear, you say?
Yes, a bear wearing a monocle, a dinner jacket and boarding first class.
But that could be any one of us.
She's right. That could be any one of us. First icebergs and now this. We are going to search every inch of this ship till we find that monocled bear. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going on a bear hunt.
Well, I'd love to join you, but I'm already on a hunt. For criminals.
Criminals?
Criminals! You're preposterous! There are no criminals on this ship.
Oh, yes, there are. You mark my words, lady, and I'm going to find them. With my Holly Hobby magnifying glass. In fact, I think I'm getting a clue. Right now!
We, she, whore,
whore! Shut up! Don't panic. After all, dead Holly Hobbies tell no tales. Are you all right?
Yes. Just dark demons from my past that follow me wherever I go.
I think I know what you mean.
You do?
Yes. Only my demons wait for me in the future. There's so much pressure on me to fulfill my namesake, to have a child, just so they can have one too. It's like I'm trapped.
Maybe we just need to learn to be in the present. Together.
Yeah. Oh! blueprints of the ship, or...?
No. It's a design I made for a French building.
Oh! It's good. It's very good. I've never been to France.
Oh.
Thank you, architect, for saving my life.
Will I see you at dinner tonight?
I hope so. Goodbye.
Wait!
Yes, sorry.
don't say goodbye.
Why?
Well, in France, they never say goodbye. They say, bon voyage.
Oh. Bon voyage, Mr. Architect. Come on, lads. Let's finish off this lifeboat.
Okay. Come on, lads. Do you hear that?
Fire!
Sounds like fire.
Good job we're surrounded by water.
Fire! 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 Very dangerous! Fire! Fire!
Fire!
Fire!
Fire! Fire! Fire!
Very dangerous!
Should we be worried about that?
We are not paid to think. Now, come on!
Brew time!
Oh, yeah. Fancy ginger nuts.
I love ginger nuts. Do you know what else I love?
What?
Birds.
Oh, what, like owls?
Of course, like owls.
What, like pigeons?
Like pigeons, yeah. I love pigeons. Love me with pigeons.
What, like a robin?
No! To hell with robins, all right? To hell with robins. Come on, let's get you sorted out.
What's where you're going, mister?
And that is the last account wired to my name. Now, for the next phase of my plan.
Towels! Get your fresh towels!
I don't want any towels. Go away!
But they're fresh!
I said go away! Now get out! Get out!
Darling, wait
a second! I don't want any sodding towels! That little girl is following us, she's stalking us!
Shut up! And get ready for dinner! We've got more explosive problems to deal with. You set the bombs for earlier, later, right?
What?
Are you listening to me?
Yes, yes! Bombs, explosions,
caused by my genius wiring, will engulf the ship in a tiring inferno. After dinner,
we'll make our way to Lifeboats by way of the first class lounge.
Which should be completely destroyed and impassable. Everyone will be trapped, at which point I'll make my way to the lifeboats via third class.
Which is where the last bomb will go off.
Exactly.
You know, darling, I was going to wait to give you this when everyone else was dead. But I just thought that the beautiful sound...
Towels! Get your fresh towels!
No. And now we're going to be late for dinner.
Step out of it. You're married to John. He's still your husband. He may not be perfect. So stop thinking about that dashing architect and give your marriage a proper chance.
Oh, John. Didn't see you there. How was your day?
Plot, scheme, murder.
Productive? I went for a walk around the ship. Nearly fell off. Saw some bears. And met someone. Some people around. I definitely wasn't alone with a man. Wonderful hair. Oh, you're so tense, John. Do you know what would help with that? Consummating our marriage.
I can see it now. Fires. Spontaneously igniting all over the ship. Growing.
Oh.
Growing as my impending victory swells.
Swells!
To a deafening crescendo!
John, I can give you such a crescendo.
It's time!
Why don't you take me now?
John! Come back here and befriend me!
What's this? John! Diary of a Megalomaniac by John. As a poor, optimistic, and talented electrician, I could wire anything. Wires and money. The planet's future has been short-circuited by the rich elite. Oh, my God. Oh, there's not one word about me! Wait. When Grandma and everyone on Death Ship is dead, I'll have enough money to bash Wall Street. That's what they'll call it, the Wall Street Bash. It just goes on and on. Fine, in that case, I'll get ready for dinner. You know who'll be at dinner, don't you?
To your right, there
there is a fabulous dinner party with all of the ship's elite. I wasn't invited. To your left, there is also an Irish jigging room for our third class passengers. Make your way now, please, madam. No, it's fine, I'll take it. I do everything round here anyway. I just want to get on with my tour, which continues right this way.
So, I originally wanted to fill the deck with clutter, but it was thought by me that the deck would look too cluttered, so I was overruled by myself.
Fascinating. I'm just filled with confidence knowing you're steering this vessel.
After 8 minutes.
Wait! What time is it?
8:05.
Right, go on then.
We were just saying, Captain, how we can't wait to see the explosive headlines when we reach Bermuda.
Yes, yes, I'm sure the captain will be dead famous.
Then we'll just destroy the ship and cash in on the disaster.
Cash in on the disaster!
Captain!
After dinner, mint, Mr. Architect!
This is no time for mint!
But it is after 8!
Captain! A word!
Mr. Architect, come and meet this funny rich couple!
No, you don't understand. I've been checking the ship and it's a powder keg waiting to blow!
What? Has that Holly Hobby been talking to you?
She's a natural liar.
Who? Holly Hobby.
No. It's the wiring.
Oh,
it's
no.
All wrong. We need to change it and check the ship for anything else suspicious.
Oh no, the investors won't like that.
Not one bit.
Well, the investors, oh, but I thought you were the investors.
We are.
We won't like it.
Oh, just listen to me.
Imagine the explosive headline.
No, Captain, you don't understand. This is wrong. It's just not right. It's just...
Architect, you came.
Of course I came. I couldn't stay away. Where's your husband?
Oh, he's somewhere plotting on the ship. He's been so aloof and distracted recently.
I can't be jealous of a man who's missing all your beauty.
You think I'm beautiful?
I'm sorry. I've been too forward.
Oh.
Grandma, there's something I'd like to talk to you about. About my past. Oh, but it's a bit hot in here, isn't it? Perhaps we could go outside? I'd like to talk to you in private.
That was close.
Too close. Let's keep them distracted.
Good idea. Who'd like to join us in a parlor game?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes. I love that.
And that's what flying a plane feels like.
Now, let me show you what it's like to be a helicopter. Because it's all in bending your knees, and then you raise your arms in the air like this, and then just swing them round and round and round like this.
What is it you wanted to tell me?
Well, that was it.
You've taught me so many new things. Sounds silly, but since I've met you, I don't feel so...
alone.
Architect, I was thinking earlier about your blueprints, and I've decided. I want you to draw me. I want you to draw me like one of your French buildings. Wearing this. Wearing only this.
Grandma, I can't draw you. You're married.
No.
I can't.
No, you don't understand. I'm like a building. A wonderful building. One that's never been entered. And I just need someone special, someone I trust, to come inside. Wipe their feet on my welcome mat. Explore my hallways. Need I go on?
You had me at building.
Yes, oh.
Sorry, I can't!
I'm walking away!
Poor people have such a good nose for 20.
Oh, she's so poor! She actually comes from up north!
Darling, a little poor right there.
Oh, no.
I just love Rich Man's Bluff. What game should we play now, everyone?
Everybody stop, something terrible is happening.
What seems to be the matter here, Dilly?
I can feel disaster heading straight for us. We need to get off that ship now.
No, we don't. Now, why don't we stop being paranoid? Paranoid woman. Everything will be fine. It'll be all right. Let's just find you a nice place to relax. And get you a cup of tea. So you can just calm down.
No, you're right. I'll just calm down.
Can't have her upsetting the rest of the passengers. Lock her below deck for her own safety. You'll be fine. No need to worry, everyone. Nothing to panic about. Not while I'm steering the vessel.
Captain. There is no one steering the vessel.
Absolutely!
You know, darling, I was worried for a moment there. But now I'm really looking forward to destroying the ship and everyone on board dying horrendous death.
Oh, God. Oh, I'm on to you. I know there's something going on here. And I'm going to figure out what.
Shut up! I'll distract her. You go get the sack. Go on, off you go. Should you be at school, little girl?
School's for chumps. I've devoted my life to solving crime. So remember, I'm watching you.
Oh, damn it!
She somehow got away.
Oh, she's a resourceful one, I'll give her that. However, everything is still proceeding as we have foreseen.
And when the bomb explodes, we'll be rich!
Come on, everyone!
Who said third-class parties are more fun?
Man, I love this song. Where did I put my Holly Hobby tap shoes?
Oh, it doesn't matter anymore, Grandma. Would you care for this dance?
I thought you'd never ask. Gosh, I've never danced like this before. You're wild!
John, you're here. The after aimants have all gone, I'm afraid.
No matter. Soon everything will be gone, ma'am. Now, if you'll excuse me.
No, I know where you're going. You have to destroy our merit in this ship with your silly wires.
What? Shut up, you stupid woman!
No, I won't shut up. I can't be with a man who's trying to kill me enough.
I knew it! And I'm going to stop you and save everyone!
You can try now! Get out of my way! Yes!
Yes! Grandma!
I'm okay!
Oh, we need to stop him!
We will, just as soon as this dance finishes!
Ladies and gentlemen, the King and Queen of the Charleston will be announced right at the end of this dance!
I know you've been planting bombs all over the ship, and I'm going to tell someone, and then you'll both go to jail just as soon as this dance finishes. Oh boy, you betcha!
Oh, that resourceful brat has annoyed me for the last time. Ready the cyanide, my sweet. We're going to kill her just as soon as this dance finishes.
And when the bomb explodes, we'll be at the top of a watery gold mine grave.
Oh, darling, speaking of the plan, did you set the bomb for later?
I told you I set it for earlier.
Earlier than later, earlier than before.
Come on, everyone. 20 seconds left till we announce the winner of the Charleston competition.
Captain, I have reason to believe a bear has infiltrated this party.
A bear? Good golly, Miss Holly. Don't let him see you talking to me. I'm acting on a suspicious girl. Keep dancing. We'll get those bears just as soon as this dance finishes.
It's funny, even though my husband's trying to kill us, I feel happy.
Oh, Grandma, I know exactly what you mean, but I really, really have to talk to you about my past. But just as soon as this dance finishes.
I set the bomb for earlier.
But if we both set it for earlier rather than later, that would be the bomb.
Very good, very, very good.
I guess we're fine.
I think I won.
Oh!
granddaughter. Their death ship 666 was sinking, and not for the first time that day. It was all quite arousing, especially with that dashing architect running around the deck with his shirt off. The electrician was exciting and dangerous, what with his murderous ways and running around deck with his shirt off. But you know, you can't have everything. Sometimes in life, you just have to keep your shirt on.
Grandma, please put your shirt back on and finish the story.
I'm getting to it, child. I'm getting to it.